Time for a 5-minute deck tech, and this time it is with Morophon the Boundless, the catch-all cop-out commander for cast-off creature types. But we're not interested in a specific creature type here. MP Coil MTG sent in an everything tribal list. These creatures don't necessarily have a type in common, but they have mana costs in common, and Morophon the Boundless is here to take advantage of that. This deck lets you dump colorful creatures into play for free with Morophon the Boundless, and even has mechanisms built into it to deal with the wild divergence in creature types. So let's get to it and have a look at what this ridiculous list is all about. With Morophon's ability, creatures without generic mana in their mana costs come down for free as long as you pick the right creature type. So if you make Morophon into an angel, you can play Maelstrom Archangel for free. The same is true with Avatar and Child of Alara, Scarecrow and Reaper King, and so on, although it doesn't affect the bestow cost of Chromanticore, most unfortunately. This means you can sneak these hard-to-cast gold creatures into play with Morophon's ability, but this isn't the only way you can take advantage of what these creatures are all about, because a lot of them are legends. That means you can search them up with Cissé, it means you can cheat them into play with Kamahl's Druidic Vow as well, so there's plenty of other little synergies that you can exploit here. The creatures don't have to have Wooburg in their mana costs in order to be cast for free. All the Nephilims, of course, come down for zero mana, as do all of those four-color commanders they printed a couple of years ago, and you get a very steep discount on cards with restrictive mana costs, such as the Mimeoplasm or Xur the Enchanter. Xur, specifically, is a very important piece of this puzzle, and we'll discuss exactly why in just a little bit. For now, however, let's talk about the enormous diversity of creature types. You can't concurrently name Nephilim, Soldier, Ooze, and Wizard with Morophon, which means you have to pick and choose in order to cast stuff for free. Worry not, because this deck has built-in reset mechanisms with a bunch of blink effects. Momentary blink, flicker, ghostly flicker, all the way up to settle beyond reality mean that you can flicker your Morophon, reset it to a new creature type, and start casting whichever cards you've got in your hand for free. Repeatable blink effects like flicker form, for example, are at an absolute premium with Morophon, as it means that you can reset the creature type you picked whenever you draw a new card that you want to cast. In addition to all this, of course, these blink effects can be useful in saving your creatures from removal or re-triggering into the battlefield effects, so they offer a good amount of utility while also playing into your deck's plan A. But we can't forget we're playing a 5-color deck, and in order to actually make it work, we need a bunch of fixing and, of course, a bunch of ramp to cast our 7-drop commander. Farseek, Cultivate, these are the perfect cards to use in a deck like this, as they'll help you to cast these gold cards without actually always relying on Morophon's ability. Tempt with Discovery and Smothering Tides are sort of bigger ramp cards that help you hit those 5 colors that you need, but when we're talking about a 5-color deck, there's no better fixing than Chromatic Lantern. This is the best in the business when it comes to making sure you've got access to all 5 of your colors. And in addition to that, of course, it helps you ramp from 3 to 5, which means that on turn 4, you can untap and slam a Wooburg monster into play, no worries at all. But now we get to the really good stuff, Arcane Adaptation and Conspiracy. When you play these cards, you can name any creature type. I heartily recommend that you choose something like Brushwag, Sponge, or perhaps Coward. And as long as you name the same type with Morophon, all of those ridiculous 4-5 color cards that are so hard to cast otherwise are free. They don't cost anything. All of them concurrently at the same time can be played with Morophon's ability. But it gets even better, because with Arcane Adaptation and with Conspiracy, cards like Scion of the Ur-Dragon and Sliver Overlord can now tutor up any creature in your deck, because these enchantments also affect creatures that are in your library. This is incredible, and also one of the reasons perhaps that we don't play Xenograft in this deck, as it doesn't provide the same amount of utility. But wait, there's more. Call to the Kindred and Descendant's Path, in conjunction with these key other enchantments on the left, now mean that you're going to be swimming in card advantage, as every single creature in your deck now shares a type. While this deck still does some very sweet stuff without cards like Arcane Adaptation, it takes the deck to the next level once an enchantment like this is out, and that's the reason that Xur the Enchanter is so critical, as it can tutor out cards like Arcane Adaptation, in addition to some other pretty cool stuff, Necropotence, Rhystic Study, that sort of thing. But with these enchantments online, this deck goes from being sweet to absolutely bonkers. It's a completely different game once you've got Arcane Adaptation or Conspiracy paired up with Morophon, because you can just spew out all these ridiculously costed gold creatures until your opponents have had enough. This deck rules. So it's another big thank you to MP Coil MTG for sending it in for us all to enjoy. If you want to see the entire deck list, of course, you can see it at bit.ly/everythingtribal. And if you've got a list you'd like featured on this program, please send it in to me on Twitter at Riley Quarry Tower. But that's it for this 5-minute deck tech. Thanks for hanging out with me, and I'll see you next time.